This video is brought to you by Cool Green Clothing. Cool Green Clothing is a Baltimore-based clothing line that started back in 2018 and has been growing strong ever since. Make sure you follow Cool Green Clothing on Facebook and IG at Cool Green Clothing and check out their website, coolgreenclothing.com, where you can find the latest Cool Green fashions and hats, women's apparel, and the latest men's collection. Remember, if you ain't coolin' and getting the green, you're in the
red. Yeah, shout out my nigga Cool Green on a fit though. Got me drippy, you heard?
Oh man, check out my man. Yo, you feel me? Yo, be getting me right, huh? You feel me? Big clothing for real, you feel me? Come with everything for real. I'm grabbing everything for my man, yo. You feel me? Shout out to my man, yo. You feel me? Support, you heard?
Exactly, yes, sir. Man.
Cool Green right here, Saddy. Cool Green, you already know, downtown B-More, that's where we at. You already know, representing New York, Harlem shit right here, uptown. But we downtown right now. You see that, my man? Yo, come and get my man Cool Green. Rock it, you see it. I'm gonna make it look good for niggas to get. Daddy, sales is going up today because of the Cool Greens.
And I'm telling you, follow Cool Green Clothing. It's so important for us to support our entrepreneurs. There's so much talent in Baltimore. And as a creative entrepreneur myself, I know how hard it is. And I love to see just people going out there and going for their dreams. So let's get it. Bless up.
What is going on, YouTube fam? It's your boy, Tony Two Times. And we back with another episode of the Baltimore Way, man. And tonight, we're going to talk about Lynell, Tinsy, Denise, Lonely, a.k.a. my mother. This a near and dear story to my heart, so let's get right into it. So Lynell was born in East Baltimore in 1971. You know what I mean? To Lavinia Oakley, that's my grandmother, and they lived over east. They eventually moved to Lafayette Projects. That's where my family from. My mother, she liked to sing, she liked to dance. You know, she was talented. She was real short. That's where she get her nickname, Tinsy, from, due to her height. I know a lot of y'all out there might know her, but this will give y'all a better understanding of why I do what I do. And she definitely got a story that need to be heard. So growing up, you know, my mother was energetic. You know, life of the party. Everybody loved her. She also liked to fight, you know, so everybody knew her down the projects for that. But at an early age, she met my father. That's another story within itself. He got put out of his home at an early age, you know, and he was like 15 when he came down to projects. Him and my mother met, and you know, long story short, at an early age, she got pregnant with me at 14 years old. My pops was 15. So when she gave birth to me, you know, this in the 80s, I was born in 87. So before that, you know, they like to turn up, they like to have fun. They like to drink, smoke, you know, back when they was drinking 40s and all that. But unfortunately, my mother got caught up in the heart of the Baltimore drug trade. And, you know, she started abusing narcotics. You know, she was hustling on the side, trying to make money, do her thing, you know, support me. We was all living in the projects. My uncle, my grandmother, my great-grandmother, my cousin, you know, we was deep. But it was a family thing. Everybody looked out for each other. And you know, like I say, she was young when she had me. So my grandmother and everybody helped. My father had got locked up like a year later for, you know, hustling in the projects. But my mother, she was out there by herself trying to make things happen. She told me a story one time where she had took a pack from the Jamaican dudes and some New York dudes. And then on Christmas Eve, they grabbed her, they snatched up. They took her down to Lake Clifton. Then they told her, like, did you buy your son something for Christmas? Because she was like, I got a son. So she said they was going to do that to her. But because she said she had a son, they understood. They had beat her kind of bad, but they let her go. So that was a blessing. So later on during life, like I said, she was trying to shake her addiction and do right by me. One thing I can say about my mother, she always gave her best, no matter what she had going on. But when my father came home, he moved down south to get himself together and start a better life. And then once my mother realized that, you know, her addiction, she had to beat that and she had other issues going on, she sent me down there with him. Now, I went down south with my father, but I eventually came back home to live with my mother. Around about this time, I'm gonna say my mother was like 30, like 29, 30. And you know, she had tried to get clean off the hard stuff, but she had started drinking. So it's like you escape one thing, but you go to something else. Then my grandmother and my aunt and all them, they felt like moving her from the city would help her escape that. So they moved to Rosedale, Baltimore County, you know what I mean? Y'all know Golden Rain Mall, Fontana Village, all that. But like I say, she was drinking a lot. Now, picture yourself in this situation. My great-grandmother only getting one check a month. My mother only getting one check a month because she had got hit by a car on Monument Street. It broke both her legs, so she wasn't working. So they was getting like five something apiece. So we had rent, we had other utilities, stuff like that. That's what pushed me out there. But that's another video for another segment. This about her. So, you know, when I came back home, she was trying to get it right. Like I say, she was drinking heavy, but she wasn't really touching nothing hard, except on the first. Because when we, on the first, we went, caught the 35, went in town, and then we'll go on Ashton Avenue, and we'll go to my aunt's house or something, then she might grab us something. But I tried to keep her away from it as much as possible. My cousin had went to rehab at the time, and you know, they was running buddies. They used to do their thing together, her and my cousin Shawnee. But my cousin had got clean in Philly, got her a job. She was doing real good. She got her apartment. We tried to get my mother to stay. She cried. She didn't want to stay. You know what I mean? But when we came back home, I was just talking to her like, Mom, I just want to see you get clean for once in your life. I want to see you be happy and see something else besides Baltimore, because she had a tough life. My grandmother died, unfortunately, when my mother was maybe like 27. You know what I mean? I was young when my grandmother died. And you know, just growing up, she had it rough, you know? And she always had to fight for what she had, but she tried to keep some character about herself and some dignity about herself. So during the course of all this, my mother had things going on within her body. Now, the day that she left this earth, I was outside, you know, I was smoking, we was talking, and she told me she couldn't breathe. Now, my mother used to play a lot. She was on the oxygen machine, so I thought she was playing. But like I say, we was living out the county. They took her to Franklin Square. She ain't make it. The moral of this story, man, from 14 years old, my mother fought addiction. She just couldn't get herself together. All I wanted was for her to get clean and live a better life and see something else. I salute my father because he gave me an opportunity to see something else when he took me down south. Even though it ain't work out because I kept getting in trouble, but I saw something else. But yeah, rest in peace to all my angels, my Aunt Penny, my mother, my grandmother, my Aunt Diane, my great-grandmother Granny, that's her right there. After she passed away, that's what made me leave Baltimore, because I felt like I ain't had nothing left, you feel me? So, man, this story near and dear to my heart, but I just wanted y'all to hear this. That's why I talk about what I talk about, because my whole family been through this, you know what I mean, come from this. But yeah, man, leave your comments below. Let me know what you think about this video. Rest in peace, Mom. Love y'all, fam.